The USS Clamagore, named after the blue parrotfish, is a submarine built for the US Navy during World War II. It's classified under the Beleo class, which is one of the largest classes of subs in the US Navy with 120 boats. And when we say the largest, we mean large, weighing in at 2,429 tons. As you can imagine, a submarine of this magnitude would need up to 70 people to man it. In the case of the USS Clamagore, however, it housed a whopping 80 men at one time.
I'm honored and amazed anyone would want to serve on a submarine having been down there. You know, even with five of us down there for 30 minutes talking, it's stuffy, it's cramped, you really can't move freely. And you're thinking, how in the world did someone come down here and put 80 people with two toilets and stay down here for months at a time?
Unlike its predecessors, the Clamagore significantly improved the strength of its steel frame, allowing it to operate deeper underwater with a higher stress point. Not only did they improve the material makeup, but they also made several technological modifications during its active years, updating many features like the masts and periscope shears, along with the addition of a snorkel and hull extension.
One of the amazing things about these ships is how they planned all the wiring and plumbing and stuff and built them as quick as they did.
The Clamagore was a true diesel-electric submarine. On the surface, its four diesel engines powered electrical generators, which took over during the submerged propulsion. This hybrid transmission allowed a submarine to travel slowly and quietly while the engines remained at full power to recharge batteries quickly.
An attack sub like what Clamagore was, running on its batteries, you wanted to run as quiet as you could. That meant shutting down a lot of the systems. If you were being stalked or having depth charges dropped on you, you wanted to put as small of what they call footprint in the ocean as you possibly could have.
Although the Clamagore was built during World War II, it was still in training when the war ended. Still playing a vital role in US military operations, the Clamagore reported to Key West, where it patrolled the East Coast while working with the Fleet Sonar School.
She was converted after the war to be a Soviet sub-tracker. She would chase around the Soviet boats and train incoming submariners to do the same thing.
In 1948, the Clamagore was converted to a Guppy 2 submarine to increase undersea performance, later being converted one last time to a Guppy 3 model. It remains the only surviving example of a Guppy 3 submarine.
As far as the Guppy 3 conversions, most of those all started taking place in the very early 1960s. You know, the Cold War with the Soviet Union was really heating up.
The Clamagore finished out its tenure as a surveillance boat, and after 30 years of operation, it was decommissioned and struck from the Naval Register on June 12, 1975.
In the 70s, the US Navy was retiring a whole fleet of these type of submarines. And they said, who wants a submarine museum? So she became her new life as a museum 30 or 40 years ago here in Charleston, South Carolina.
Since her donation to the state of South Carolina in 1981, the USS Clamagore has served as a reminder of continued adaption and use of war-built diesel submarines by the US Navy.